Please stand and join in singing our opening hymn, Amazing Grace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Amen.
I'd like to welcome you to St. Patrick, St. Anthony's Parish today. And so wonderful to see such a nice group of people here today to remember Bob, not only for his life, but also to remember him in your prayers. My name is Father Norm. I'm retired. I kind of live in the area, and I'm very happy to join with you, the members of the family and friends and fellow parishioners of Bob, as we commend him to eternal life today. We are gathered at a ceremony like this for two basic purposes: to remember Bob. And so I would suggest that during the ceremony, you at least remember one particular item about Bob's life. Maybe how he related to you in a very special way. Maybe something he did, maybe something he said. Something that really impressed you, that made you a better person, a different person. So just, you know, think of one thought. And secondly, I'd ask you, we're here to give thanks to God for the presence of Bob in the lives of so many people, to say thank you to God for his service to our country, to his family, and also to his friends and his church. We begin with a short litany of thanksgiving for the life of Bob, and after each part of the litany, please respond with, "We thank you, God." We are grateful, God, for the ways Bob touched our lives. Together we say, "We thank you, God, for being loving and lovable to family, friends, community, and workmates." We say, "We thank you, God, for the times he shared our sorrows and listened to our problems." We say, "We thank you, God." And for the times he showed us forgiveness and accepted us when we made mistakes, we say, "We thank you, God." And finally, for the example of goodness that so many received from him, we say, "We thank you, God." A long time ago, Bob was baptized, and his journey with the Lord began. And his earthly journey, as we know it, is now concluded. But his journey with the Lord continues in the realm of the eternal. At this time, I sprinkle his remains with this water, as a reminder of that day when his journey began, and as a reminder that his journey, even though he has passed through that threshold of death, continues on with his Lord in eternity. And let us pray. God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servant Bob will also rise again. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. For those of you who are not familiar with our Catholic rituals, the first part of today's ritual consists of the reading of the scriptures, which I think most people are familiar with. The second part of our ritual today consists of the Eucharist. And so during our ceremony today, I encourage you to participate in the various prayers and so forth to the best of your ability. Let us now listen to the Word of God and the words of Jesus in the sacred scriptures. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. And he will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all new things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
My shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an account of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. And blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. And blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. And blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In behalf of the members of the parish, I'd like to extend to you, the members of the family and the friends of Bob, our deepest sympathy. You are in our thoughts. Bob will continue to be in the thoughts of the rest of the parish this coming weekend during the general intercession prayers. And today, during the intercession prayers, we not only pray for Bob, but we also pray for all of you as well. So we hope that in this atmosphere of prayer, you will find comfort, you will find peace within your lives at the loss of Bob. There are, of course, those many memories that so many of you have of him. And even though our loved ones pass through that threshold of death, nevertheless, this is not the end. They continue to live in our memories, and maybe even in some of the actions that we are accustomed to be doing. Our loved ones live in the joys of God's kingdom in heaven. As the readings remind us today, there is no more death, even though we pass through that threshold of death. Those memories continue on, continue to live on, and our loved one continues to live on in the love and in the embrace of God and his Son, Jesus Christ. This is a wonderful season that we have. We have gone through Holy Week, and on Good Friday, we recalled the death of Jesus himself. He took upon himself our humanity, and he even took upon himself those sorrows that come up in life, and especially that pain and sorrow that is associated sometimes with having to let go of life as we know it, and to put ourselves in the trust and in the hands of God. But on Easter Sunday, we see where death does not bog us down. It does not end a life that God intended for us to have. We rise up, just as Jesus did, to eternal joy and eternal happiness in the kingdom of heaven. This is a wonderful time for us to renew our faith in that passage that we all go through, that Jesus himself went through, that passion, that passing from death to eternal life. Today we hope and pray that Bob will find that eternal joy in the embrace of his Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. In one of the readings today, there is the comment that I am the Alpha and the Omega. The Alpha, of course, is the first letter, the beginning of the Greek alphabet. And the Omega is the last letter, the ending of the Greek alphabet. So the Lord is our beginning, the Lord is our end. But that end does not cease at the moment of death, but our life continues on even after death in the kingdom of heaven. We follow in the footsteps of Jesus. We follow through those footsteps that we usually associate with dying, so that we might live. During our lifetime, there are many deaths that we have to go through and deal with. There's the disappointments of life, maybe our expectations that we have for ourselves or that others have for us are not met completely. There is maybe the rejection, the misunderstanding that maybe others have of us. And as we kind of look at the life of Jesus, we see that his life was no different than ours. But yet, through his constant faith in doing the work of his Father, in his constant faith to do the will of God, he was able to suffer through those less than glorious moments of human life. And he suffered through them, and eventually death was overcome by him through his resurrection on Easter Sunday. And so Jesus is the beginning of our life as well, and he is the end to which we strive, to that resurrection life that we all hope for someday. You know, God would have been a terrible God if he would have given us that gift of life and at the same time just kind of snuffed it out and took it away completely. But that's not the way that God operates. Once he gives, he does not take away. And the readings of today's Mass keep reminding us that he does not take that life away. That life that we treasure, the life that we want to go on forever and ever. Jesus had that same desire to live on in his humanity forever. We follow in his footsteps, and this is our hope. We have faith then in that passage from death to new life, especially the life of eternity. And yet, we realize that we are called upon to walk in those footsteps of Jesus. Not only the footsteps from that passage from death to eternal life, but also to walk in his footsteps as we live our life as we know it here and now. That gospel reading today reminds us that we must respond to the events of human life as Jesus did. There are those who are poor in spirit, who need to be supported in their poorness by us. We must uplift them in their times of doubt, their times of suffering. The first reading reminds us that we must, you know, comfort one another in those times of great difficulty. It reminds us that even though there is that tendency to maybe react with violence towards one another, especially in those moments of anger and pressure, yet we must be meek, and we must encourage others to be meek at times like that. Of course, there are those who have hungers, who have thirsts, and these are so many and so varied and so different. There's that thirst for meaning in life. There is that thirst for security in life. There's even that thirst for someone greater than ourselves in life, a greater power. And that, of course, is a thirst for God. There are the many hungers that people have, the hungers for companionship, for recognition. There are the physical hungers, the hungers for food and clothing and the daily needs of life just to survive. There's also the need for peace. You know, as we look around us, we see that there are many people that are not at peace. This happens in marriages, it happens in families, it happens on a worldwide basis. I think we're all conscious of the many wars that are going on throughout the world today. And so there are people in need of peace so that they might find joy and happiness in life. We must respond then to be those peacemakers, leading others to that joy and happiness. And sometimes it's not easy to walk and do the things of the Lord. And towards the end of that first reading, talks about being persecuted for the sake of the kingdom of heaven. And so when it comes to, you know, trying to step forward to do the things of the Lord, it is not without difficulty. And yet the Lord is there to guide us, to support us, and to strengthen us. This happens through prayer. It happens through the Eucharist that we celebrate and receive. So our life then is that life of passage through death to eternal life. It is a passage from that old beginning, that initial beginning, to that new beginning, which happens over and over in this life. And it happens eventually to that final letting go, that final dying to the things of this earth, so that we might have the things of heaven. Life and love with God, with each other and all the saints for all eternity. Today we celebrate then the passage of Bob from the shortcomings of this life, and even though he enjoyed his life, nevertheless, there was that greater joy, that eternal joy, which never ends, which never fails. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. At this time, I'd like to invite all of you to respond to some intercession prayers. And the response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. Please rise as they are proclaimed.
In baptism, Robert received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Our brother Robert was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet, we pray to the Lord. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son, we pray to the Lord. Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace, we pray to the Lord. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. The family and friends of Robert seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Robert. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Good and gracious God, continue to comfort us in our moments of sorrow at the loss and the death of Bob. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. At this time, the altar will be prepared for our Eucharist. Two of the grandchildren will be bringing up the gifts for the Eucharist. And during the preparation now, you may be seated.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Robert may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. In Christ, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed but not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. With angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing this hymn to your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
And please kneel or be seated, as is your custom. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of the death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, all the clergy, and each other. And remember your servant Robert, whom you have called today from this world to yourself. For a few seconds now, in the silence of your minds and hearts, think of that one item of Bob's life that perhaps meant so much to you, that maybe impacted your life in a positive way. And in that silence within you, just say a simple, "Thank you, Lord, for Bob's presence in my life." Grant that Bob, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our other brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
And please stand. As we pray the Lord's Prayer together, we pray not only for our own daily bread, but we pray that we may also be daily bread for each other's lives. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. Give those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom. And Lord Jesus, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. At this time, we have the custom of wishing each other the peace of Christ. And if you so desire, it can be done with a simple peace or some other significant gesture.
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no wings. Your refuge is faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day. Though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Robert, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. As part of our song of farewell, there is the use of incense, and the incense is used to honor a very special person, to honor God, to honor others who are made in the image and likeness of God. Let the fragrance of the incense be a reminder to all of us that we may be pleasing not only to God, but also to one another as we journey through life. And let the rising smoke remind us that we must constantly direct our earthly life towards our heavenly life. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Robert, your servant. In the sight of this world, he has now passed on, but in your sight, he lives forever. In your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. This now concludes our commendation of Robert to eternal life. And I believe there is a luncheon prepared immediately afterwards in the parish center. And so if you're able to attend, certainly I'm sure you will not be disappointed by the luncheon. And now, may the Lord be with you. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever and ever. Amen. We go in peace to love and serve the Lord and each other. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art.